पहले तो पीछे नहीं
कुछ पहले भूसा आपका कैमरा आ रहा है लाइट से लाइट मज़ा नहीं आ रहा
जाएगा फोटो सब
चलो आ जाओ
The unfortunate part is not many would take a stand like how you have taken a stand to spend some time with my beautiful kids who are waiting to listen to you and also to of course our dear friends from Norway. And a very good morning to all these beautiful children who are seated here from our primary and middle school, all our teachers, the coordinators, and the support staff and people who are waiting for this beautiful day. I was speaking to our friends from Norway, and kids, you know what I told them? That we are so happy to connect with one more European country. We already have partner schools in France and in the Netherlands. Now we have one more friendly school and friendly people from Norway, which is one of the most beautiful cities or countries in the world. But look at us, we are a population of 24 million people. And I think Norway is 5 million. Yeah, and Norway, they're coming from a country of 5 million. So they're like babies when it comes to population, you know. So, but however, I think it's the interest that they've generated in being with us this day that seals it. I'm very appreciative of the fact that Afroz has been able to spend a lot of time, or we've been able to spend time with a very tireless worker called Afroz Shah, who we connected last year. And let me tell you, kids, Afroz has picked up more plastic in this world than anybody else. So can we get a round of applause for Afroz? And I want to make a public commitment, which I know I'll have to carry and be careful when I say this. But our commitment is for the sake of our city and our country. I may be a little selfish when I say this, but along with Afroz, it's a cross that we're ready to carry. And ensure that our children who are listening to us today, who will learn from what we do and not what we speak, will be able to take this as an example which they will set for their families and their children. And let me tell you, WIPCOR today is more than 50,000 students across 4 states and 6 cities of this country. And we are having a population of more than 16,000 families who are going to sing the same song that we're singing here, that we're going to reuse, recycle, or even refuse. That's another thing that we left out. But that's what we're doing right now. And let me also tell you, we have started that approach as a practice. We've already begun that. We are going to reduce, we're going to reuse, and we're going to refuse the usage of plastic in our schools, and it's rightly begun here. So I'll keep my introduction short, and I would only say, you're most welcome, our dear friends from Norway, our dear friend Randeep, from the film fraternity, who is going to spearhead this because he himself is a great social activist, and that gives us a lot of solace and comfort that there is somebody who listens to this children's plea. Thank you, principals, for being here. We'll spread this message to our friends and families, and all the volunteers from our process team, most welcome. Please feel free at home at WIPCOR High. This is going to be your school, and you're going to help us, and we're going to help you. It's going to be a partnership that's developed from June of 2017. And we're going to take this forward. So we'll work hard and we'll keep this going. Once again, my namaste to our friends from Norway and my best wishes to everybody seated and warm welcome once again. Thank you and please feel welcome.
Good morning, WIPCOR. Good morning, Mumbai. And good morning to guests from Norway. Thanks for the wonderful introduction. It couldn't have been better, the word tiny. You know, you take off from things which are tiny in life. Let me tell you, Shiv, and kids who are listening. When you start with tiny things, you reach the pinnacle of height and success. And maybe the success will come or not come, we don't know. As I was speaking to Randeep in the car, it's a journey which is very important. So you have to start tiny. And that's exactly what me and my volunteers did at Warsawa. I'm sure a lot of kids from here have visited Warsawa. How many of you all have visited Warsawa? Oh God, so you know all of us. Randeep raises the hand too. Now, instead of talking about me, my volunteers, what this moment about, you've seen the movie. I want to talk about some of the guests here. You know, I want to do like a little detour and deviate from what beach cleanup is to people who are actually standing for these activities, whether it's a beach cleanup, or going into the slum, or educating people, or handling plastic properly. First of all, let me talk about Randeep. Everybody knows Randeep is a great actor. You've seen it, but I've seen a side of Randeep which not many people are aware of. You know, during Ganpati cleanup, last year we were cleaning for 10 days. And one night at 10:30, 11, we were at the beach, 100 of our volunteers trying to clean plastic, and Lord Ganesha's eye from there. Randeep walks in and cleans from 11:30 till 3 in the morning. Tell me which Bollywood actor would do that. You know, generally our perception about people who are in public life or who are actors or who are on public platform is you do what I call awareness. Awareness in this world means go and talk. Go and talk about the problem. Explain what the problem is. But here was Randeep, who didn't want to do that, but he wanted to do ground action. He says, my hand must do the talking. My hand must indicate the message. And I'm sure when he put out that tweet that night, when he came back and he put it out, it went viral, his tweet and my tweet. It sent a message to the world that there's an actor who means business and who means business at the ground level. It's not sitting in a five-star hotel or holding podiums and talking about what the environment and the problems. The problem is in front of you, go tackle it. Use your hands, put your hand to produce. So that's Randeep. And not only that, he keeps on in constant touch with me on phone, messages. He's very worried. He's a very worried man, as you all are worried. He's worried about what is happening to our environment. He's worried about what's happening to our nature. He's worried about what's happening to our oceans. And he's doing his bit. That's Randeep Huda. I had an absolutely fabulous journey with him for the past 1 year. And as Shim puts it, it's after all a partnership. So my partnership with them continues in that capacity. I think the next I should talk about is Mr. Thor. I don't know how many of you all know, he'll come on the dais to talk post me. But let me introduce Mr. Thor is a deputy councillor at Norwegian Embassy. You know, I tell some of you kids have seen him on the beach. He wears a t-shirt at the beach every time at the cleanup. The t-shirt says, just do it. This is Thor. So I asked him, why do you wear just do it? Somebody said it belongs to Nike. Nike also has a symbol. So I was worried, was he branding himself as a Nike ambassador at the beach? But he gave me a beautiful logic. He said, Afros, you know, in your country at least, there are too many laws, policies, regulations. Everybody talks about environment protection. Everybody talks about how to love your ocean. Everybody is worried about the plastic problem, but very few do it. So I want to give a message, just do it. So he is keeping on doing it for 2 years with me. He just comes to the beach, cleans up. Then he took a step forward. He comes to schools with me. He comes to the slums. And then he prepared a proposal with Nordic Council, which I found completely fascinating. Here was a man from Norway who's been posted at different embassies all around, and he's so concerned about the ocean, he prepares a proposal to Nordic Council saying that, can we go ahead and support? So that's talk for you. Now, regarding Vibhyor, then what do I say? Kavita here. Yes, Kavita. Kavita here. I remember visiting your school when you organized the UN. Model UN. And that time Kavita and Shim took the burden on themselves. They said, we will be the change at the ground level. And here you are after one and a half year working, you know, kids from Vibhyor working on roster system every month, every week. Then the Norwegian team, the whole team from Oslo, I was told Raymond, Oslo's mayor was supposed to be here, and unfortunately he met with a terrible accident. We pray for his quick recovery. Sad news, otherwise Raymond would have been with us here. But let me tell you, the Norwegian delegation, Norway has been a fantastic partner. Norwegian's consulate has been a fantastic partner with me in the ocean cleanup. The problem of marine debris is huge, and when you see people holding hands, as you did, kids, you all came and held my hand there, and I said, Afroz, don't get worried, don't lose hope. We are young, but we will do it with you. That gives you the hope and love and a feeling of going ahead together. Big round of applause for the kids from New York. And yeah, you all have heard my talk about marine debris and marine data. I don't want to bore you much. The lawyers keep on talking. Give me another 2 hours, I'll keep on talking. You have no problem with that. My profession demands, so I think I should invite Mr. Todd to say a few words from the Norwegian consulate. I think he should share his experience and what he feels today about his own journey for 1.5 years. But one thing, kids, I'll have to tell you before I give the mic to talk. You know, I am as concerned as you are about the problem of plastic pollution, the health of the environment. But you know, one thing which comes to my heart and mind, which I want to share with you, is sorry, I have to apologize to all of you here, the young kids who are between the age group of 6 to 20. We were supposed to protect the environment and ocean for you. We held it in your trust for you. We adults have messed up, and that's why every function when I address the kids, I say, sorry, we could not give you the beach. You know what, a kid in Europe enjoys the beach as you should be in Mumbai. But you come to the beach to clean with me. And this is not your doing, kids. This is doing of all adults here who are sitting here. Our life of convenience has messed this planet up, has messed this city up, has messed the ocean up. So my apologies to all of you all for not being able to give you the ocean, the beach, the forest, the mountains, the lakes, and the rivers as you should be enjoying. But you are here now standing in the 21st century, holding hands and saying, we'll clean with you. I think a big round of applause for kids who have stood up for this. And as Shimin Kavita says, we have a long journey to go, and I always tell people, we are in for a long haul. Don't expect miracles to happen, we all work hard. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra, God bless all. Sorry for my
National Equestrian has a profound fondness towards nature and has galvanized people to keep the city from becoming a dumping ground. He has made it a point to request the authorities to not make the mangroves a waste. So, I would request you to please share your perspective with us.
Morning. I haven't been to school for a long time. And I'm very, very happy to see you all. And I'm very glad that I don't have to go to school anymore. I would rather be at the beach. In case if I'm in the beach in India, I would be cleaning it rather than enjoying it. I love it. I love it when you give me this badge and there's this thing. What I stand for, I stand on. What does it mean? What does it mean? Anybody?
These days there are two dustbins. What are they called? Are they different colors?
What colors are they? Tell us, tell everybody. So what do you, where do you put the paper? In the green one for recycling, right? Thank you very much. So if all of us had walked past this paper and nobody had picked it up, what would it become? Waste. Well, it will become litter rather. So, I'm sure on all your books and all of us talking, we are all saying keep it clean, but how do you keep it clean? By picking it up and putting it in the green dustbin. Which dustbin? Right. I'm so happy that all of you are so aware of all these things. And I've got a lot of hope for the future because of schools like Vipure and people like Afroz. I meet a lot of people who talk a lot about the environment, tweet a lot, but nobody actually goes and does it. This young girl, she picked the paper up. You see, we had all talked about, okay, let's pick the paper up. We should pick the paper. We should, you know, littering is not good. We should pick up the paper. But somebody, like this beautiful young lady, did go and pick it up, right? And then it made a difference. So I truly believe that if you really want to do something, if you have ideals, like Afroz had an ideal for, and he started alone, and when he talked about tiny man with a big heart and great ideas was also Mahatma Gandhi, right? I always say that if one man starts with a purpose, which could be any of you kids, any one of you can be Afroz, can be Mahatma Gandhi, can be any great person, can be Sachin Tendulkar, can be anything you want to be, if you decide to do it, right? Right?
Yes.
So, I'll tell you about Afroz. The tiny Afroz. I used to read newspapers. Do you guys watch news? Do you have news in your school assembly? Yeah? So similarly, I used to watch news and I felt that the whole world is a bad place now, or it's a scary place, or it's a dirty place, and nothing can be done about it. It was overwhelming, this feeling. So I started sourcing out people, you know, like in films we all wear makeup. All your moms wear makeup, right? So in films, even the daddy or the man wears makeup, right? So I was looking for heroes that did not wear makeup but were still heroes, might not be famous. I wanted to bring attention to them. In that process, I found in my own neighborhood a man who's going to go clean the beach every day by himself and encouraging other people, not forcing anybody, inspiring them to join him. It is a movement which is a citizens' movement because one man took the lead to go and do it. And what is the most important thing about that? It is doing it consistently. Consistency in life, whether you are studying, or whether you're playing a sport, or you want to become a film star, or if you want to become a Afroz, I think the consistency is the key. So I saw this man doggedly doing it every day, and I went to meet him once to meet him in person and see what the kind of person he was. And all he talked about was environment this, that, and but what he did not do was he did not sit at home like most of us and say, it is someone else's job. The government should do it, the PMC should do it, or some other organization should do it. What he did was he said, I am going to do it, I am going to make a difference, I am going to start alone if I have to. That kind of snowballed into this movement which has now put Versova, Andheri, Mumbai in the world map in a very different way, where it is not doomsday, you can make a difference. I said a joke to Afroz, which I can't tell you guys here. But that really, really means that you got to take up one thing and follow it through. And I'm very glad that Afroz showed me the way, as he showed a lot of us, a lot of you young children, the way to make a difference is to go pick up the... And when you go by, all of you eat chocolates, right? You eat candy, eat chocolates. So whenever your parents go and buy a chocolate, how can you make a difference? Bob, tell me, sweetheart, come here.
No! रणजीत सर
Turn our bottles to the volunteers. Alright, children? Can we have a huge round of applause for our novices here? Hello, that's good.
तो मैं काफ़ी सालों बाद एक स्कूल में आया हूँ. पब्लिक स्पीकिंग में कभी प्रॉब्लम नहीं हुई, पर एकदम से बच्चों से बात करने से पहले मुझे बहुत नर्वसनेस फील हुई. बहुत अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस है. मैं बहुत खुश हूँ कि सब लोग बच्चे इतने एजुकेटेड हैं, उनको आज पता है ये सब क्या प्रॉब्लम्स हो रही हैं और उसके सोल्यूशंस उनके पास हैं एंड द एंथुजियाज्म. और मेरा ये मानना है कि आप आजकल क्या हो रहा है कि सोशल मीडिया एक्टिविज्म हो रही है. लाइक कर लो, शेयर कर लो, रीट्वीट कर दो तो तुम्हारा काम हो गया. पर वो एक्चुअली में काम करता कौन है जाके? इसीलिए मुझे अफरोज़ बहुत पसंद है और बहुत टाइम से मैं उसके साथ जुड़ा हुआ हूँ कि वो एक ऐसा इंसान है जो खुद जाके अपने हाथ से करता है, एक डिफरेंस मेक करता है, ना कि घर बैठ के हाँ कि ये किसी और का काम है, मैंने शेयर कर दिया सोशल मीडिया पर तो मेरा काम ख़त्म हो गया. और वो इंस्पिरेशन हर बहुत स्कूलों में जाके अफरोज करता है, बहुत जगह जाके करता है. तो आई थिंक जो एक इसने खुद ने एक आई एम अफरोज जो इसने एक वो चलाया था वो अभी इतना मोमेंटम पकड़ गया है. और सबसे ज़्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट चीज़ है कि स्कूलों में लोग जो इन्वॉल्व हुए हैं वही हमारा फ्यूचर है, वही आगे बड़े होकर अपनी हैबिट्स और अपनी इंस्पिरेशन ऐसे रखेंगे. So I'm very, very happy and very and with you as a school. I think their involvement by their committee, by their principals, by their teachers and their students is amazing, and I think other schools should take a leaf out of this book and involve children, because once they go clean it by their hands, they will realize what they and their parents and everybody around them is doing to the planet, and they will be more careful. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Question about film,
about the
sorry, I apologize.